When we were together, I held you down. I gave you all of me, but look at us now. Thinking of all your excuses, but they don't add up. Now it's so easy to see you don't deserve my love. You pushed me far. You brought me to it. You had my heart, but then you blew it. Oh, and I'm so over you. Go get lost. Who do you think that you are? Trust and believe me. You're gonna need me. Trust and believe me. He'll never be me. And I'm so over you. Go get lost. I don't know who you think you are. You look so foolish with my best friend. And he ain't no better than me. He's a 3, but I'm a 10. So why are you calling my phone? You ain't got nothing I want. Thought we were really in love, but that was all a front. You pushed me far. You brought me to it. You had my heart, but then you blew it. I'm so over you. Go get lost. I don't know who you are. Trust and believe me. You're gonna need me. Trust and...
Good evening, icons. My name is Vincent Tennell, and you are watching The Vincent Tennell Show. We do have a special guest with us today. His name is Dr. Camayo. He is an associate professor at UIS of the African American Studies. I want to thank you, Dr. Camayo, for being here today.
My pleasure.
I just want to get straight into the questions.
Okay.
Is President Obama the best thing that ever happened to black people?
No.
Why not?
He's the president of the United States who mm-hmm. happens to be black. There haven't been a lot of things that he's tried to or been able to allow to attempt to do for black people specifically. Now, as a role model, he's been pretty good. And I think his legacy is not going to be made by what he's done in the White House.
Mm-hmm.
He's suffered a lot of disrespect of the office, more so than any other president in history. But once he retires from the presidency, he'll still probably have a very active life, and he'll be able to do some things then. So perhaps no is not the best answer to that, not yet.
Mm-hmm. Not yet.
But looking at a number of other people and historical figures, in terms of people who've been able to do things and done things for black people and represented them in different ways. You know, I've had a lot of conversations about this with other folks. Certainly Frederick Douglass. I don't think he compares to Frederick Douglass at all with respect to that. Some might argue for someone like Marcus Garvey or Booker T. Washington. You know, when you look at the civil rights movements themselves, emancipation, those kinds of things in terms of the best things that ever happened to black people.
Mm-hmm. So do you believe African Americans focus too much on education or not enough?
Not enough. I mean, I have no doubt about that. There are too many ways that they do not focus on education. Just some of the popular presentations of someone who speaks properly,
mm-hmm.
talks like they're white.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I've been in schools at all levels.
Right.
I've taught from kindergarten to graduate school. And the African Americans who reach graduate school are usually fairly serious, but at the undergraduate level and throughout K through 12, no, they're not, and it often comes from the family. There are a lot of ways that African Americans distrust institutions, and education is one of them. Some of that is from the disservice that the educational institutions have done to the African-American population.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. But a lot of that is we don't have the cultural capital, and people are looking at doing other things, and they have other priorities rather than the schoolwork.
So if we matched, let's say, informal education with entrepreneurship, would that be equivalent to formal education to you?
When you say informal education, are you talking homeschooling, you know, Saturday school?
No, I mean people who basically teach themselves how to succeed in this world rather than getting a degree.
I think you need to have, and I'm not talking about higher education as such. I'm talking about the basic K through 12, the basic skills.
Okay.
I mean, there are ways that you can teach and deal with a high school degree that focuses on the skills that you have.
Okay.
But if you don't have at least a high school diploma, it's hard for you to be functional in this society. There's some things that you can do without it, yes. You know, and entrepreneurship, I think, is a need for us overall. We definitely need to have more business people. But with the technologies involved in business, unless you have something that makes a real big splash right off the top, you won't be able to last in the marketplace long enough. You know, now, if you're talking about service industries and those kinds of things, then possibly so.
Okay, I see what you mean. So do you believe the term African-American is a proper term for melanated people?
I guess I have some problems when you say melanated. Do you mean brown skin? Do you mean people from of African descent?
People of African descent.
Okay, because I mean, you know, Asians. You don't have melanin. People in India have melanin. Melanin is just what makes the skin dark. So if you talk about people of African descent, if they're in the U.S., then yes. But
why?
If they're in London, it's not.
Okay, can you explain that a little bit?
Well, the term American should not apply to somebody who's in London. Or, you know, there are people of African descent all over the planet. There are two Americas. There's North America and South America. So the people in the U.S.,
okay, so
if you want to consider us as Americans,
yeah,
and if we are of African descent, then that is accurate as a label for our ethnicity.
So what if you have someone who was born in Africa and they come to America, they migrate? Are they able to use the term African-American?
Why not?
Because I wouldn't go over there if I migrated and called myself, let's say, Nigerian-America, just because I migrated.
Well, but see, if they are here and they're trying to become a resident, then that's one of the things that when you immigrate into a country, you are doing that for a reason. So if you become a citizen, and if your children are citizens, that makes it an appropriate label.
Yeah, but now it seems to me, the more people I hang around my age, I'll say, they don't want to be called black. They want to be called mixed. Black is offensive to them.
Yeah, I see that. And they bought into a lot of the negative and pejorative stereotypes. They don't want to be called African or African anything.
So I say, if you don't want to be called black, why even claim to be mixed? You know, why?
Well, once again, the truth in advertising, if I changed my name, I'm Kamau Kamayo now, but I'm still a Shelton. My family is Shelton. My father was a Shelton. My mother was a Woodard. Those are my family roots. I don't deny those because I changed my name. So now if your father is of one ethnicity, quote unquote race, and your mother is of another, are you going to deny their background and say you're not one of those? Are you not both? See, because this goes back to when black folks were enslaved, or the period of neo-slavery afterwards, when the black woman, when the African woman was freely available to the white man who impregnated her and created stuff like this. Okay, they couldn't claim that white man as a father. So they were black, they were Negro, they were just plain slaves or whatever. But now in an era when multiracial parentage is accepted, that creates a problem. That there wasn't a problem with this 80 years ago. There wasn't a problem with this 180 or 280 years ago. They were seen as Negroes. They were seen as Africans because they could not claim the white part of them, because the white part of them, for the most part, did not claim them as other than property, even though they're sometimes better treated than some of the darker
Absolutely. Folks. I just think there was a more cohesive unit amongst black people when we had a common thread to say, okay, you are black. Now it seems this kind of divide and conquer thing going on when we get to basically creating another race.
I mean, I recognize that, but some of the things you said make me think you're more about the divide part of it rather than the
And I get that
part.
Quite often.
Okay, so maybe I'm right. Okay, so.
You may be right, because I think as African-American people, we do need to have our own if we're going to move forward.
Our own what?
Our own sense of, like, businesses. We need to have our own system of how we raise our children. Everything is so out of whack now.
When you say our own system of how we raise our children.
For everything. That was just one example.
Okay. Well, how we raise our children is something very important to me.
How we raise our children, how we conduct business, how we, you know, every other race, it is very apparent that they stick together. I mean, it's not that they hate everybody else, but they do realize there is strength in numbers and there's power in numbers. We are always so independent, and we always have to be like the mulattoes or mixed ethnicity people. Somebody always has to be different. Nobody can really just get in the group.
Well, I don't know if it's about that. What it is, there are the social and cultural pressures to assimilate.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, in terms of accepting a culture, perhaps that is not or was not your own at one point.
Mm-hmm.
And having much of our cultural expressions and our cultural and community autonomy squashed during an era of slavery.
But I will say, if I look back to the 60s and the 70s and even the 80s, we had these leaders born, like the Malcolms and the Martins and things like that.
Well, they were born back in the 30s.
Well, I'm saying when they were at their height of pushing forward for our people.
Okay, yes.
So not so much of them being born.
Okay, but as they were doing it, when you say Malcolm and Martin, you're talking about people who died in the 60s.
Died in the 60s, and they were at the height of the struggle, and they were in the public. That's what I mean. That's when the leaders, we saw these leaders. I do not see that today at all, not even from anyone.
You don't see black leadership now?
At all. That's respectable.
Well, I mean, you know, Al Sharpton is trying to do some things. You know, and there are ways in which you could argue that Oprah is, but in terms of that kind of a political mm-hmm. leadership and perhaps an adversarial leadership.
Someone
and,
who's willing to die, basically.
Well, I mean, I don't know. I don't necessarily see that either. But I don't know that that's what we need as a people.
You don't?
No, I think some of the cohesiveness that we need is a general program.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and part of that is where the family starts.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things is, this is a pet peeve of mine, so mm-hmm. and we've kind of gotten off
no,
of
let's
where
just
we started,
go wherever the conversation
takes us.
No, I think
this is a very good conversation to have. And I think parents, black parents, need to take much better care of their children in just about every way but how their children look.
Mm-hmm.
Now,
absolutely.
The children will look good, but they'll have many other problems and things that they aren't necessarily concerned about. And mm-hmm. a stable family life, I think, is one of those. I can't begin to count the number of African Americans who I've talked with who say, I'll do anything for my children.
Mm-hmm.
I'll do anything for my children. You know, whatever it takes, I'll do it for my child.
Head down. I watch my feet take turns hitting the ground. Eyes closed. What I feel no one else has to know. And I'm soaked in your love. And love is a ride in my path and my grasp. And me and you. We belong. I wanna run, smash into you. I'm willing to run, smash into you. closed. What I hear no one else has to know. 'Cause I know that what we have is worth first place in gold. And I'm soaked in your love. And love is right in my path and my grasp. And me and you, we belong. I wanna run, smash into you. Ooh, I'm willing to run, smash into you. I wanna run, 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 no. I'm willing to run, run. Head down, I watch my feet take turns hitting the ground. Eyes closed, I'm in love with the earth. It's worth first place in gold. And I'm soaked in your love. And love is right in my path and my grasp. And me and you, we belong. I wanna run, smash into you. I'm willing to run, smash into you. I wanna run. I'm willing to run, 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 ooh, 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 ooh. I wanna run, smash into you. I'm willing to run, smash into you.
I want to move on to the next question. As far as religion, have we been bamboozled?
Yes.
Okay. So you do not think Christianity is a good thing for the Black community?
Is Christianity the religion in the Black community? I mean, see, when you ask the question like that, I said something about there's a distrust of institutions in the Black community. There's a distrust, and it's a natural and realistic distrust of education. There's a natural and realistic distrust of the criminal injustice system.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so there doesn't seem to be as much of a distrust of the religious institutions. And many of the religious institutions create, if not cause, some kinds of problems.
I believe.
For example, if you talk about, is there a gay conspiracy? Is there a mm-hmm. religious conspiracy against gay people? If so, where is that located? That would be located or started, or perhaps many religious institutions.
Uh-huh.
Would support that.
Well, what do you counter as religion? What should our people believe in if not Jesus?
I'm not saying what people should believe in. That's not necessarily my role.
If we've been bamboozled by religion.
Every time I talk about religion, I step on somebody's toes.
Well, that's fine.
So that's one of the things that's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
I think people should believe in a creator.
Mm-hmm.
Now, who or what they call that, and in terms of how they practice it, I think is much more important. If you look at the major world religions, most of them come down to a belief in the golden rule.
Mm-hmm.
And a recognition that there is a power that is higher and more important than you.
Okay.
I mean, those things are common to most religion and religious perspectives. Now, if you talk about the church and the kind of things that happen in the church, does the church exist? Is it there for the spiritual sustenance of the people, or is it there to pad the pockets of the T.D. Jakes, among others. The Daddy Divines from others. The Daddy Graces from history. And if truth be told, the Adam Clayton Powell Seniors from history. Mm-hmm. Is that what religion exists for? I've had this conversation with pastors. I've had this conversation with others.
Well, I'm not talking about
what do we tithe for
so much
well,
as the
well,
preacher.
Well, we're talking about people being bamboozled. If they're bamboozled, who are they bamboozled by?
The deity they put in front of these religions. Like when you see Jesus, you always see...
Who is the they that puts them there? I mean, you know, if we're going to talk about it, we have to talk about the role
the white people have given us an image and we have followed suit. We've done it.
Well, I mean, you know, people can give you some things that you can lose and you don't have to accept it. You don't have to put it in your pocket and fully embrace it.
I believe it, yeah.
I mean, so, and and while Christianity in one form or fashion was presented as a white religion, I think that was a perversion of the religion. And people talk about being fundamentalists, and they haven't read the Bible, either the Old or the New Testament, in the language that it was written in.
So it's not so,
and they don't even know. They can put a name on the religion, I mean, on the language that it was written in, because they don't know. But they'll read something called a King James Version and not acknowledge or recognize that King James changed the version to suit himself. So and then all the other kinds of names that are on the 6,000 different Bibles that you can buy online or in a store, okay, that they are changed for various reasons.
So
is Christianity
I want to ask you,
any longer fundamental?
It's not so much the religions have been bamboozled. We've been bamboozled by religion. It's just the perversions have distorted our,
Said religious. You said religions in asking the question rather than Christianity specifically.
Well, it's not just Christianity because I could see the same BS in Muslim. I could see the same BS in...
In Islam,
whatever. Okay. Excuse my term.
No, well, not whatever. I mean, let's be respectful of...
You say you can be respectful of something, but at the same time you agree, we've been bamboozled. So that's disrespect in itself.
Well, I have to respect other people's beliefs because there are people who believe it very seriously. I mean, so, and the label that gets attached to it, if I believe that people can be called what they want to be called, then I believe that the religion should be called what they believe in themselves.
I can get that you can correct me. I have no problem with you correcting me because, like I said, excuse my term, I did say that. But I also have an obligation to my audience who may not have your education, who may not be on your standard. I have to make sure they understand what I am saying. And when I said the Muslims, we all knew what we were talking about. Now, you can take the time to correct me, which I have no problem with, but I'm going to say, see where I'm coming from as well.
I do see that. It's not that I don't see that, and I didn't want to, you know, take this as far as it went. But, you know, once it started, I wasn't necessarily going to let it go like that.
And I'm not going
to say, if those are, is that the only people you expect to be watching this?
No.
Okay. What do you expect from them when you bring something to them?
This show is supposed to reach all mediums, all audiences, all creeds, all whoever. Now, I've said in this show from the very beginning, sensitive ears should not be watching this show because someone may get offended. Someone may get their toes stepped on, or someone may think I'm disrespectful. So they've been told that from the very beginning.
Okay, so, but my question is, should sensitive ears be doing the show?
Oh, you talking about me?
Yeah.
How am I sensitive to you?
Well, you're the one that complained. I just said Islam, and I expected you to move on and keep going.
No, you and then flat out said I was ignorant, and then... You tried to play it coy.
It wasn't until further down the line, when you kept expressing it, that I had to call it for what it was.
Let's move on.
Yes. Let's.
Okay. So my last question is, should we trust white people?
No.
Why not?
Other interests coincide with us. Should we trust black people? No. Because too often their interests don't coincide with ours. There are many different factors. We're talking about individuals trusting other individuals.
We're talking about
trusting
groups,
institutions.
As in a whole, groups.
One of the things in this society by the nature of society that there are no whole cohesive groups anymore. That you look at the people who would fit in the society, mm-hmm. they're not whole and cohesive. There are classes within any group. Mm-hmm. So should lower class white people trust upper class white people?
I don't
know. Trust affluent
white
people?
I'd have to ask them.
I would say no to that in terms of if my opinion is asked. And the same thing would be in terms of different class values and things. Mm-hmm. So what I'm saying is you should trust people who have demonstrated that they have your best interests in mind.
Mm-hmm.
You can enter into alliances with people. You can enter into relationships with people to try and find out what's going on. But trust is a relationship that should develop over a period of time, a period of interaction,
mm-hmm.
the developing of a relationship.
No matter who it is.
Right. Mm-hmm. Right. So I don't trust a lot of black people.
I don't either. But I'm just saying, like I said, as a whole. The black people I don't trust is that I know them. So I know what to look out for when they don't have my best interest.
Well, I mean, there are many black people I don't know. And I don't necessarily trust them. You don't have to know to distrust people just because you know them. You can wait and see. Mm-hmm. And that's the kind of attitude that I would say in any population looking at.
Mm-hmm.
Do they have, if you're looking at who you're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you can trust 30% or 80% of white folks, I don't know those kinds of numbers.
Mm-hmm.
But what I will say, and I have to say this, that there are many white people who I do trust
mm-hmm.
and who I would recommend that the African-American community would trust.
Mm-hmm.
In the same way that I would say there are many black people, there are many Asians, there are many people who are trustworthy, who are humanists, who have the best interests of humanity and the globe in mind.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So while we're on this question, it was the last question, but I did skip over one of my questions I was going to ask you. As far as Hollywood goes, who is a coon? Just name one person who you would consider a coon.
I wouldn't use that phrase.
You wouldn't use that phrase?
No, I wouldn't use that phrase. I wouldn't call anyone a coon.
No one a coon. So let's rephrase the question.
If what you mean by coon mm-hmm. is someone who represents the minstrel era,
mm-hmm.
the step and fetch it kinds of roles, the kinds of
yes.
stereotypes like that, probably half the comedians and half the rappers.
Oh, half.
Yeah. Without naming names.
Just throw a name out there.
Tyler Perry.
Okay, there you have it. This is the end of our show. We're going to let the people think on that.
Okay.
So I do want to thank you for coming to the Vincent Snow Show. You have brought a very, I don't even know what to call it, another perspective to this show. I think people will be talking for a while
about this interview. Invite me back so they can talk some more.
Okay, I will do that. So this is Vincent Tennell. You have an iconic evening.
Okay. Thank you, folks.
You wanna. You want a hot body? You want a Bugatti? You want a Maserati? You better work, bitch. You want a Lamborghini? Sit in martinis, look hot in a bikini. You better work, bitch. You want a live fancy? Live in a big mansion, party in France. You better work, bitch. You better work, bitch. You better work, bitch. You better work, bitch. Now get to work, bitch. We'll be right back.